Modeling paths. Modeling paths usually falls into two categories, network paths and overland paths. Network paths model phenomenon that must move through a fixed system or structure. These can include stream networks, transportation networks, and utility networks. Overland paths model movement or routes through places with no infrastructure or systematic constraints. In this module, we will cover the elements that make up a network path model. Network paths. Network paths can be used to solve a number of problems, including the allocation of resources, determining the best location based on demand, delineating a service area based on travel time, finding the optimal route. Components of a network. The network dataset. In order to run a network analysis, you first need to create or obtain a network dataset. A network dataset is a type of vector data built from a collection of related source features, such as lines and points. A network dataset also stores the connectivity between the source features. By themselves, features such as lines and points are unaware of each other. For example, if two line features intersect, neither line is aware of the other. The network dataset keeps track of which source features are coincident, and it also has a connectivity policy, which you can modify to further define which coincident features are truly connected. This makes it possible to model overpasses and underpasses without having the roads connect. When a network analysis is performed, the GIS will know which paths along the network are feasible. Network elements. A network dataset can be made up of the following network elements: edges, junctions, and turns. Edges. Edges are the segments over which travel takes place. Line feature classes can be used as edge sources. Examples include stream segments, road segments, utility lines, and rail lines. Any number of attributes can be assigned to edges, including those that may affect travel through the network, such as travel time and direction. Junctions. Junctions connect edges and facilitate navigation from one edge to another. If a junction source feature is not provided, the GIS will create a junction feature class automatically when the data is first built. Examples of junctions include street intersections, dead ends, on-ramps, off-ramps, and stream network confluences. Attribute information can also be assigned to junctions, such as the time it takes to stop at a stop sign or stoplight. Turns. Turns are optional network elements that store additional connectivity rules that can affect movement between two or more edges. Examples include a road intersection where left turns are prohibited. Network cost variables. A GIS can usually create a network dataset if provided with a linear feature. However, it may take additional time to optimize the network dataset with the cost attributes needed to generate a robust model. Cost is usually measured in terms of distance, time, and money. Network analysis is often based on modeling which path has the least cost. For example, the least cost path for an emergency responder would be the quickest path rather than the shortest one. The least cost path for a fleet of garbage trucks would probably factor in travel time, time at stops, labor costs, fuel costs, vehicle maintenance, and service time when returning to unload.